Hello everyone, this is our fourth video on PNF therapy, and in this video we are going to discuss in detail the first special technique mentioned in PNF, which is rhythmic initiation. The goal of any PNF technique is to promote functional movements, and this can be achieved by facilitation, inhibition, strengthening or relaxation of muscle groups. Lot of time in our clinical practice, especially in neurorehabilitation, we see patients who are having difficulty in initiating emotion. These patients also have problems in gaining control over the motion. That is, they might be performing the action either too slow or too fast. Rhythmic initiation technique enables the therapist to develop coordination of motion in such patients and also gain control over the motion. Rhythmic initiation technique also helps the therapist in teaching the patient to relax. So first of all, let's understand what is rhythmic initiation technique. Rhythmic initiation refers to rhythmic motion of a limb or the whole body through the desired range, starting from passive motions and then gradually progressing to active assisted motions, active resisted motions, and finally active motions which are done by the patient. So to practically discuss rhythmic initiation technique in detail, I have with me today Deepa Dangwal, who is a physiotherapy intern here at Swami Rama Himalayan University, Dehradun. And together me and Deepa are going to discuss and demonstrate how rhythmic initiation techniques can be used in clinical settings for a variety of problems. So let's begin. So before we start practically demonstrating the rhythmic initiation exercise, one more thing that I would like to share is how we should plan our treatment before starting rhythmic initiation. So the first step in this should be identifying the movement that needs to be trained. Now suppose, for example, we want to train the elbow flexion movement. Now the second step should be, we should choose some ADL activities that require the elbow flexion movement, without which they cannot be performed. Like for example, listening to a phone call, applying cream or eating a fruit. Now these options should be given to the patient, and the patient should choose which activity he or she would like to perform. This not only increases the motivation level of the patient, but also the patient now knows why this particular exercise is important, because that particular activity is going to achieve a functional goal, which is an ADL task. So let's say the patient has chosen the activity of listening to a phone call. So now let's see how we can use the rhythmic initiation technique to develop elbow function in such patient utilizing this activity. So now we have a goal to achieve, which is to train the elbow flexion movement, and also now we have an activity which has been mutually decided upon between the therapist and the patient, which is listening to a phone call. The therapist will now start preparing for the exercise, which is the mobile phone should be given in the hand of the patient. The patient will be given proper instructions of what is going to be done. So as I mentioned before, rhythmic initiation technique will have four phases. In the first phase, the therapist is going to perform the action on his own, and patient needs to remain as relaxed as possible. The therapist will then progress to the second phase of rhythmic initiation, in which the patient will be asked to help the therapist in bringing the phone up, while the reverse phase of putting the phone back will still be done by the therapist. And when the therapist will find out that the patient has started contributing enough in bringing the phone up, then the therapist will progress to the third stage, in which the therapist will start resisting the motion of elbow flexion, and the patient needs to recruit more muscle contraction to produce the action. And finally, in the fourth phase of rhythmic initiation, the therapist will now ask the patient to perform the action on her own while still the action of putting the phone back will be done by the therapist. Okay, so now the patient has phone in her hand and I am there with the patient to guide her throughout the rhythmic initiation. Let's begin. Deepa, let me move the phone up for you and let me put it down. Try to stay as relaxed as possible. Let me bring it up. Let me put it down. Very nice. Let me bring it up. Let me put the phone down. Let me bring the phone up and let me bring the phone down. Now help me in bringing this up. Help me in bringing the phone up. Let me put it down. Let me put it down. Help me bring the phone up. Good. And let me bring it down. Help me bring the phone up. Help me and let me bring it down. Very nice. Now pull up and bring the phone up. Good. Pull up and bring the phone up. Now let me put it down. Now pull and bring the phone up. Again, pull and bring the phone up. Very nice. Now let me put it down. Okay, now bring the phone up. Bring the phone up. Very nice. And let me put it down. Let me put it down. Bring the phone up. Good. And let me put it down. Very nice. Okay, so now just for the comparison's sake, let me also demonstrate how rhythmic initiation will look like if we are not going to choose a functional activity. Now Deepa, let me bend the elbow for you. Let me bring the elbow back. Let me bend the elbow for you. Let me extend it. Let me bend the elbow for you. Let me extend it. Now help me bending the elbow. Help me bending the elbow. Good. And let me bring it back. Now help me bending the elbow. And let me bring it back. Help me bending the elbow. Let me bring it back. Okay, now pull up and bend the elbow. Pull up and bend the elbow. And let me bring it back. Now bend your elbow on your own. Now as you can see, there was a major difference between both of these demonstrations. The first or the previous activity that we performed was not just a simple movement. Instead, it was a functional task, which was or which have been done by the patient innumerable number of times in her past. So the learning ability for that particular task will be much more as compared to simple movement training. Another important thing is that when we choose a functional task for the training, it becomes very easier for the brain to relearn how to coordinate the elbow joint function along with the shoulder, wrist and hand functions. That means synergistic coordination is also much more and better trained when choosing a functional task. Another important benefit of rhythmic initiation that I want to stress upon is that it was noted during all the four phases of rhythmic initiation that every time the activity of bringing the phone back was done by the therapist. Now, why it is important to be done is that we want the patient to learn to contract the muscle as well as to relax it so that the patient gradually learns to concentrically and eccentrically contract the muscle. Because in certain cases, patient has this difficulty of contracting a muscle and then finding it unable to relax it. So rhythmic initiation technique can be used to initiate a motion, learn a motion, and also to gain control over that motion by voluntarily relaxing or contracting the desired muscle groups. Now I am going to choose another task and very quickly show you how rhythmic initiation can be done for completing those particular goals. Now let's say we are having a patient who is having difficulty in initiating standing from sitting position. So now I'm not going to go into the preparatory activities that should be done prior to the exercise, like for example increasing the height couch so that it becomes easier for the patient to learn standing, or keeping an object in front for which the patient can choose to reach out so that the COG can very easily come forward and patient finds it easier to stand. I am just going to quickly demonstrate the rhythmic initiation technique for facilitating standing. So let's begin. Okay, so this will be my starting position for facilitating sit to stand via rhythmic initiation. Let's begin. So Deepa, let me bring you forward and let me bring you back. Let me bring you forward, let me bring you back. Stay as relaxed as possible, forward and back. Let me bring you forward, let me bring you back. Now help me coming forward, let me bring you back. Help me coming forward and let me bring you back. Now push and come forward, push and come forward. Now let me bring you back, good. Push and come forward and now let me bring you back. Okay, now come forward and let me bring you back. Very nice. Now there are innumerable number of tasks that we can make our patient learn by utilizing this rhythmic initiation technique. All we need to focus upon that it should be an ADL activity, and that activity should demand the movement that needs to be learned. So this was all about the rhythmic initiation technique, and I hope I was able to successfully demonstrate and simplify it for you all. I also hope that physiotherapy students who are regularly following Physio Classroom are getting benefited from our videos. Please do not forget to comment and subscribe our channel. So in the end, I would like to say, keep learning, keep sharing, and stay connected.